specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
Hi there, my name is Brigand, and I'm back. And I want to thank Neon Style, which commented on my channel and said, come on, you have so many subscribers, you have done such a good job in the past and so on. Why do you let your channel slip into meaninglessness? And yeah, he's right. I enjoyed doing videos in the past and I was very occupied with other things and I just didn't have the time. But okay, that's maybe just an excuse because I've taken the time to do other things. I want to make a video again. And the user MGPL said, Brigand, a new playthrough for XCOM would be amazing. Yeah, I did play XCOM 2 and I played it through and I really enjoyed it and I was having a blast and I thought the end mission was really hard, but I enjoyed and loved my ranger backstabbing and running everywhere and I enjoyed my sharpshooter. It's kind of my favorite class. He really rains death upon all those aliens and the hard heavy, the grenadier was good also. And the specialist, yeah, it's a kind of jack of all trades. He has good mobility. And I thought, wouldn't it be fun to play a XCOM 2 game over again with just one class? And the first class that sprung into my mind was, of course, yeah, let's do Ranger, all with swords, samurai style, and let's go for them. But then I thought, yeah, maybe that's kind of easy with untouchable and so. So I chose the specialist, the most unlikely of classes, and I will show you how I have done it. Yeah, okay, let's begin and just start the game. And I want to play legendary difficulty. You can of course tweak a lot of numbers in the game with all the kind of ini files, so yeah, but I like a challenge. Here I'm going to show you what I did to play a specialist only playthrough. So now let's take a look. If you go to your Steam directory where XCOM resides, you find a config file that is renamed DefaultClassData.ini. Just make sure you make a backup copy. And what you see here, I went to all the default classes and I commented out the Ranger, the Sharpshooter, the Grenadier and the Psi Operative. The only class that is available to play now is the Specialist, so all my rookies, when they will be upgraded, will be specialists, and so I managed to get an all-specialist playthrough. There might be a catch to this, because it might be that I don't get special traits when I have researched it from other classes, as I only have one class unlocked, so I'm not sure about that. So yeah, okay, but let's try how good it goes. Also want to say something. I'm playing on Ironman mode and the hardest difficulty, but of course you can tweak a lot of the ini files and fiddle around with percentages and so on. This is not to prove that I'm a very diehard player or whatever. I'm just doing that for entertainment purposes only. I just want to see if a specialist squad is able to, yeah, and the game basically without the other classes. So that's what it's all about. Right now I have only starter characters, so let's look how we are doing with those. And yeah, if you play legendary Iron Man and you're just starting over a new game, it might happen ever so often that you lose all your squad or you get a lot of casualties. So don't be afraid to start over again and just try for a new game. And that's what I did here also. I think I had 3 tries that were quite horrible. I got 2-3 casualties. I don't think I had a team wipe, But I will stick with this playthrough now because this went rather smoothly, so it's kind of cheating, but you're just starting over until you get the first mission where not everybody is dead and you try to go from there and look how far you can come into the game. So here we go. I invite you to join me on my journey and this playthrough XCOM 2 All Specialist Squad. Let's do if those jack of all trades are up for the task. Let's do it! The mission is quite basic. I have to neutralize all enemy forces and sabotage an advent monument. This will be hard enough, and I think this is my third try starting the game all over again. You can see Lenny Kravitz in the back and Buffalo Bill on the left front side, and we also have Steve Jobs, may he rest in peace, and we have Britt, it's my aunt from Norway, and she looks a bit similar to this Britt here. So here we go. Okay, we see some baddies already, and we're still concealed, so that's good. The thing is, we have so little life. Normally, if you get shot with whatever you are hit with, 4 hit points, chance is pretty high you are dead. And if you aren't dead, the chance is pretty high you are injured for weeks and weeks and weeks to come. So always try to get into either hard cover, and if this is not available, try to go for hate advantage, because you will get a bonus. So Britt is going up here now, and maybe that's not the best of decisions because she has no cover there. The middle tile on the watchtower here has no cover whatsoever. But I try to just basically kill everybody in Overwatch fire before they get the chance to fire back. So here they go. Yeah, they have not spotted me yet. So we're still hidden. And I think we might already shoot those guys. Let's see. Yeah, we're doing Overwatch. And Steve Jobs, maybe. That's full cover, so this is a good spot to go to.
Close it on target position now.
And I think I will shoot with him. And the others just go on to Overwatch, because when they dash into cover after we have taken 66% chance. Let's do it. Oh boy, I'm so lucky. But like I said again, I think this is my third start of the game. And I was a bit unlucky with the prisoners, so now please hit. Of course. Oh, great. So we have one living with one HP. I have already a promotion earned, so. Yeah, I love firing from an height advantage because you get a better percentages to hit the enemy and you have some kind of protection, but without cover, so Brit here is really in danger. Buffalo, Bill and Lenny Kravitz do have some cover. Yeah, but I think I will finish this like I did. Yeah, Brit, great shooting. Yeah, so this might be a little bit tedious because I'm playing very conservatively and very, shall I say, I'm just waiting for them to come to me. They're patrolling around a lot and I rather like to have my action points on Overwatch and just get them killed on the end of their move if death is ever so possible. So I think I will let those three guys and the one woman stand on top of the tower and Steve Jobs. Yeah, no, Lenny Kravitz. I will dash into hard cover here. Yeah. What I do with Steve Jobs, come on guys. Yeah, we Overwatch.
Come get some. Scanning.
So another round of Overwatch. But I fear I have to move out if I don't get any patrolling enemies. And I'm just looking for hard cover. Uh-oh. Yeah. So, okay. We still have patrols on the marsh. So let's look if we can bait them into an Overwatch trap. Oh, my auntie Brit is still kind of in danger there. Still no cover, only height advantage. I don't know what I did there, actually. So, okay, this is of course a recorded playthrough as I wanted to get sure that I get a head start that is actually of some value to show and just not ends in episode 1 of my playthrough. So, Buffalo. Come on, Letty. I'm afraid they won't show up and patrol where I can get them. So I think, I think hardcover. That's good, but I can't shoot.
Will do.
They're still around. Yeah, always go for hard cover. Remember, soft cover gives you minus 25% to be hit. Yeah, okay. That's the objective. And hard cover gives you minus 50% chance of being hit. So, hard cover is 25% better than soft cover. Always try to go for hard cover if ever so possible. And the height advantage, I think, gives you 20% bonus not to being hit. I really like to take some action with Lenny. Okay, Buffalo. Let's do a round. I don't know what I was thinking, because Brit is always standing there and she could have gone one step to the left and be in soft cover and thus 45% chance not to being hit, so that would be kind of better. Okay, here we have them.
not sure whether it chalked it up to training or stricter mind control.
Oh, come on. Come on. Yeah, I have to retreat because Lenny Kravitz, he will die certainly because his mates can't help him. But now we have steered those guys and I hope that we get some good Overwatch turret gunfire. And Buffalo. Yeah, good shooting. Still alive because he has a lot of hit points. Yeah, Lenny can't do much because he's just went into hard cover, but that is all he could do. He just baited out the enemy. Oh, come on. You can't be sincere, but he still lives. Oh, yeah, he will be injured for weeks if he survives that mission. Oh boy. There's so many great musicians that have died this year, so Lenny Kravitz, please stay alive. Yeah, I'm kind of anxious to just run him as far away from the enemies as I possibly can. Yeah, Brit, come on. You are better here, you. So you got soft cover and height advantage, and you go Overwatch and oh, okay. And Steve Jobs goes Overwatch. What do I do with Lenny? I'm unsure. I think I will just run him out of sight completely, so he is no valid target. And I hope the others just get some Overwatch. Oh yeah, I'm marked. Okay. Yeah, mark this, enemies get a chance better to hit him, so come on, Steve. Great shooting.
Hostile neutralized.
Great shooting. And here we have the other. Oh, Overwatch fire. That's bad. That's bad. 26% chance. That is really not good. If I could destroy the cover with a grenade or maybe... let's take a look. Come on, Steve. You reloaded and you're overwatching. I can't move Lenny Kravitz away because then he's certainly dead. He's marked and enemy troops are on Overwatch 45%. Let's go. I love you, Buffalo. So still one Overwatch fire I have to avoid. Yeah, peek. Let's see. Hunker down. Yeah. Yeah. They go for him. Oh no, 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 no. Uh-oh. That's bad news. I was really, really lucky there. Because he has no cover. He only has the height advantage, minus 20%. I was really lucky there. But now Lenny Kravitz might, do the job. 45%. Almost 50-50 chance. I'm not sure how many enemies there are still around, but still I have to blow up this monument there. For sure there have to be another alien and not only advent troops, so there might be a sectoid in the level. Yeah, I'm almost sure there is a sectoid in the level, so let's go. So six are dead. So I expect only two more troops. Six are dead. Yeah, six are dead. So I only expect six more troops. No, two more troops. to be in a level. So they are possibly only 8 troops to fight in the first mission of the game. Come on, Steve. You're standing in the open. I don't know what I was doing there. I think I thought it was soft cover up there, but it isn't. It is no cover at all. Lenny could... Oh, he has only 1 hit point.
Understood. Moving out.
Yeah, I must play very conservatively with him now, so he has only 1 hit point. If he just gets scratched, he just will bleed out and I have... Yeah, he will be dead. If you wonder, I have, of course, in the editor, made some nice looking chars, which I imported into the game, so I have some nice characters to play with, so, and that's, I came up with Steve Jobs and Buffalo Bill, and my aunt Brit, and Lenny Kravitz, because I think he looks cool. Yeah. So the tactic is, I will have my 3 guys overwatching from the tower, and basically Lenny Kravitz will be the runner that tries to, yeah, get the attention and run for his life while the others cover his retreat, so to say. I heard something. Kind of nervous there.
Sell a copy.
This is very dangerous indeed, because Buffalo Bill and Brit and Steve Jobs, they're far too way out to help Lenny if anything bad should happen, so I'm just speculating really that I am not seen here. I'm almost certain that if I peek 2 more steps I will get seen and shot and be dead, but I'm trying to get my mission accomplished like I did now, and yeah, now it's time for me to Yeah, I have to kill them, so... 1 hit point. That's not much. That's really not much. I think I have to leave my safe position and... Yeah... I think I have to leave my safe position and help him out. Still, I am hopeful that I am able to make a run for it and just lead them to the guns. If I go 1, I think there might be enough. Yeah, right. Nothing happens here, but if I go 1 further, I can see around the corner and enemy can see me. So that's also a tactic. Just don't try to get seen, basically, and you got no enemy aggro. So now let's take a peek. So I see them now. Are there only 2? Yeah, there are only 2. Like I assumed, there is 8 enemies. A sector pod. Yeah. Sorry, not a sector pod. It's a sector hit, of course. No. Oh boy, they flanked me. Oh boy, they flanked me. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I think I'm dead. Oh boy. Uh-oh. Yeah, okay, he is just making zombie aliens. Yeah, glad he did not shoot at me or take over one of my guys. And if I say take over one of my guys, certainly Lenny Kravitz, because he's the only one in range.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Okay, we get some Overwatch fire. Four. Oh boy, just only a sectoid. So only the sectoid. Yeah, this is going quite well, really. Yeah, still Lenny Kravitz lives. Maybe he will get a chance to. Yeah, I just have to run him as far as I can in hard cover. Tried everything to get away from the zombie alien now, and Overwatch. Yeah, they will come to me. Yeah, this is quite easy. So that's a good strategy if you can manage to get basically. So oh boy, he's doing what I planned for. 4 damage. That's good. 4 damage. That's even better. There's 2 left, I think.
What's happening?
Uh-oh. Okay. Oh no. Buffalo Bill. Buffalo Bill is taken over. No, he's panicked. Okay, not as bad as being taken over. That would be great if a shot. Yeah, no chance. There are too many hit points. Really, I don't care all that much about the zombie here, because I just killed a sectoid and the zombie is gone. So I think I might try to get a sectoid with granite throw or toss. Only two hit points I have to. There are only 2 hit points I have to take him from, so should be possible. Something you might need to know, because all those zombies and the later on the chrysalids, they are melee only, right? And if you just block the ladder, there's no need for that right now, because I'm very optimistic that I will manage to toss a grenade. Come on, Lenny. Yeah. Civilian. Okay, civilian will be safe. Let's do it! And bada boom. And zombie alien will die. Yes. Okay, and that was my first mission, and yippee-yeah! All survived. Okay, although Lenny's really badly injured. Yeah, what I wanted to say is, you can always put a soldier of yours on the top of the stairs and block the route to the roof. Melee troops can't go up there, and you can shoot them, but of course be careful. If there are other troops around, they can toss grenades and so on and so on. But I think that went pretty smooth. So Stevie, William, Lenny did survive. Mission complete, and we will now have our let's play from this point on. So this was the playthrough that went rather smoothly. Still pretty much chance to die in every next mission. 4 hit points is really not that much if you've been shot by alien plasma guns. So I really make it a priority getting armor, I should say, but I won't, because I think offense is the best defense has always been. I'm going to research laser and plasma guns as fast as I possibly can. So here we are.
Our troops continue to exceed expectations while working.
And we got 4 promotions.
Impressive, command.
Take a look. Surprise!
Some of our most advanced equipment.
I got a specialist. Yeah, so actually this is working quite well. With tweaking of the ini file, just commenting out all the other soldier chips will get you guaranteed level ups of the troop types you want to. So you can use it yourself if you want to. I found it rather attractive to go for sniper or ranger. Yeah, certainly an all ranger gameplay might be very cool also. But as I said, I wanted to go all specialists. Still, we only have the basic skill, so not much to do yet. But the drone, of course, the 3 DPS. Sometimes if you I don't know how often an enemy survived with just 2 hit points and he got grenades and plasma launchers and everything, and he's behind hard cover, and as long as you have a sight, you just can kill him with the drone. So we have 4 specialists now. Here's my auntie Brit. Yeah, and that should be the end of my episode 1.
Commander, to the research labs.
Impressive, isn't it? Capable of generating immense power, yet completely harmless to human life. If only the same could be said for the rest of the aliens' technology, Commander. Dr. Richard Tigan, Chief Science Officer. I am responsible for the entirety of our research here, as well as the procedure you so recently underwent. Welcome to my lab, such as it is. I'm not sure what Central may have told you, but we found something while removing you from the alien stasis suit. A device implanted directly in your occipital lobe. Had I access to the equipment available to me during my tenure at Advent, I would already know the precise nature of its function. However, given time and your approval, of course, Commander, I assure you, I will find out. Which brings to light an additional point. Though aspects of this facility are indeed impressive, I am but one man. Were you to direct additional support personnel and resources to me, I could substantially improve the speed of all our research. A farewell, Commander. I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing options available. We'll begin work immediately. I'll send word when a complete report is available. The resistance is slightly more organized than I had imagined based on the rumors.
Okay. Reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander.
If I can build something useful,
you'd medikit, be surprised how big of a difference some of these things can make in combat.
I think I will need one medikit, and flashbang grenades are great, but I just want to save the supplies. I think.
I just hope it's not metal fatigue.
Yeah. Oh boy. 14 days. I think we will get another. Doesn't she look sweet? Okie dokie. She will be my healer. That's why she has red and white armor. Yeah, first aid, right? And So let's take a look if we can do something more useful.
Commander, good to see you on your feet again. Welcome to the bridge, the nerve center of our operation. The aliens have our entire world in their grip. Advent controls everything. Government, communications, industry, not to mention the military. And it's on us to take it all back. Resources and time are tight, Commander. It'll be up to you to decide how to best use both. The ship is yours.
While we prepare for new operations,
let's try to get the next mission and end the playthrough there. So,
on your order, we'll start our scans on the surrounding area. Commander, one of our resistance contacts just tipped us off to a site that may
I will get scientists if I research that supply there. Come, let's pass time.
Commander, the Avengers remote scanning capabilities will help us search the area for clues or other resources.
It's going to
take some time, though. We've got a lot of ground to cover.
There it is. There he is, Dr. Vladimir Zhidorov.
Support staff to assist me, Commander. I will make sure they are.
And 7 days for supplies. Yeah, I will do that. But I think we will get another alien mission before we get the chance to.
I have made a number
okay, research. What do we research?
That work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you.
Yeah, maybe we take a look into hybrid materials because research time is very short, so I think we take this. But I will go for magnetic weapons as fast as I possibly can.
New orders, Commander? There's room for us to expand our facilities on board the
Avengers,
but we'll need more engineers to clear out space for construction.
Yeah.
I'm going to need more help on the engineering team before I can start clearing out some of these other rooms. We should recruit an engineer.
Yeah, I think we buy a guerrilla tactic school. I do have the supplies. Let's do it.
The facility right away, Commander. I'll send word when it's up and running.
There's not much I can do now, really. Just passing time and wait for the next missions. Okay, we got a new target, we got a new mission.
As the resistance continues to grow, we'll have a better chance of finding openings to strike back at Advent.
And if we do this mission, we get an engineer. Well, we need engineers, so. Okay.
We'll have to move fast.
So we do this mission, but I think we end this playthrough here. And commence with the mission in the next playthrough. Thank you for watching, and yeah, see you later.